And now, let's get drawing in the do-it-yourself film animation show. Starring your old friend, Hiram HB, Erasmus Eraser, and Freddy F8. Thrill as they chase the elusive muse, Irene Inspiration. Will they ever catch her? Will you ever catch her? Watch this episode and learn something to your advantage.
Lazy people out there who want to get maximum effect from minimum work, I want you to meet the arch idler of all time, Terry Python Gilliam.
Terry, what advice do you have for people out there who want to make film animations?
Well, Bob, don't. Keep well away from it. It's dangerous, nasty stuff. Could be catching and most certainly can leave some very nasty scars, especially on those kneecaps of yours. Seriously, though, I think if you're going to learn about animation, I think you've got to learn about cutout animation as well. The whole point of animation to me is to tell a story, make a joke, express an idea. The technique itself doesn't really matter. Whatever works is the thing to use. That's why I use cutout. It's the quickest and easiest form of animation that I know.
Tell me, Terry, where do you get your cutouts?
Good question, Bob. You can get cutouts anywhere, actually. You can get them from magazines, from books, from family albums, from studio walls, like so. Amazing they were here. Bit of luck. Let's take a few of these here. There. These sort of things. You get them from old pictures. I use old pictures a lot. Great people, great faces. Magazines. Great. The thing is, you can just chop out what you want. That man's face is tremendous. You can put in a cartoon body on it. These are amazingly funny people there. This one was from a Sunday supplement. These three old ladies. Duke of Wellington fits on very nicely and works. Backgrounds. There they are. It's all done for you. You do things like this. Take these perfume bottles, take it out of that context, put people in that size. You wouldn't know what they were. It'd be an amazing futuristic city. The thing is, with cutouts, you can play around with scale a lot. You can take rocks like this, put it against the sky, then put a little town in there. It completely changes the scale of it. The rocks, you know, aren't really what they appeared to be. You can combine things in amazing ways. Terrible joke. You can use any old rubbish. Pictures of Bob Godfrey. And if it's Christmas, why not use Christmas cards? One thing to remember on the Christmas cards is that everything you see there has been cut out and retouched. You need two Christmas cards or two photographs of the thing for everything you use. This is the church with the steeple that fires into the air. That's cut out of one. Then the other one is retouched, so you've got it no longer in the background there. So it goes and it's gone. Otherwise, you'd have a big hole there. The thing is about cutouts, you want to cheat as much as possible. If people can be avoided walking in on legs, do so. This man's on wheels. It's a lot simpler, the movement. You merely roll that and move him in. It saves a lot of time. People, when they speak, rather than elaborate mouth movements like Walt Disney and everybody else uses, I just use a cutout mouth that pulls down, just like Bob did earlier on. It's messy, but it works. The problem when you're doing cutouts is to be totally aware of the limitations of cutouts. There are definite limitations, but you can use that to an advantage. You do simple storylines, you do things with quick, sudden movements. I think violence, that's what I'm always accused of doing, violent things. Well, it's because of the nature of cutouts. It's much funnier to do a quick thing that goes like that than a smooth, graceful movement, which I can't do on cutouts. Mm. So they tend to be violent or sexy. Ooh. Because there's no way of getting accurate, realistic motion with cutouts, the easiest thing to do is forget about it completely. In the Christmas card, we used the camel and the wise men. The camel's legs never moved. They just simply slid across like that. Actually, then slid back. Other sorts of movement you can do is a bouncing up and down movement. Again, very simple. The legs are one piece, the body's on another. The hippopotamus bounces into shot and just bounces up and down a bit, bounces on, bounces. Very easy, no work. And be silly with your walks. That's one of the nice things about cutouts is when you actually start playing with the bits of paper, you find some surprising things happening. This guy walks by having his foot start coming out of his stomach, swings around in an arc until it hits the ground and his body catches up. And then the next foot slides out of his belly and on it goes. Now, we're actually gonna go through how I make a film, or a film section. First thing is to make a storyboard. That's what this is down here. It's a very crude thing. I understand it, and possibly you will. First frame is a man pushing a pram into shot, pushes it across. Below the shot, I put the sound effects I'm going to use, wheel squeaking, things like that, footsteps. They're walking along. I reckon it's gonna take about 3 seconds to get him across, so I mark that down so I remember. He then comes in another shot. You can tell it's another shot because there's a building here and there's also a little lady waiting for him. Takes about 2 seconds to get the pram in. Pram arrives up to the little lady, pauses for 12 seconds. She then starts to speak, and as she speaks, she starts to bend in. She says, oh, what a lovely little... That's the sort of idea that we'd do a storyboard on. It's really to remind me as I'm down shooting the thing, because when I'm actually shooting it, it's when it comes alive. Once I work the storyboard out, I start working on characters. Here's the old man and the pram. The old man, in this case, I airbrushed, because I like airbrushing. The thing is, you could use a photograph, you could use anything, you could use simple drawings. The thing that's nice about airbrushing is it's 3D, and that's the nice thing about using photographs and cutouts. You can't do that in regular peg bar animation. You've got to use simple flat colors. But with cutouts, you can use very round, rich things. Here's the old man, made two legs for him. That's all that's necessary to walk him through. The pram doesn't need anything to be done on the wheels because they're round. You won't see them moving anyway. The old lady's a bit more complex because she's got to bend. So she's in three parts. It's the lower part, torso, which fits on like that, and her head. They can all be moved separately, and you can achieve a considerable amount of movement there by just that. The pram is gonna have to close, so we've got an extra pram top here, which will fit in behind, and we can animate it close. There's also going to be a fight inside the pram, which we can achieve with just bits of black paper stuck on, changing the positions. There's one position there, there'd be another position somewhere like that. It's fighting in all directions. Then, once I've got the characters, we start coloring them in. I use felt tip markers, generally. They're quick, they're easy. You can use anything you want, you can paint. You can use things that are already colored in. Once they're colored in, we cut them out. That's what Bob's doing right now. He's using a scalpel, the kind you buy. You can buy them in art stores. They're medical scalpels, just like doctors use, cutting open your little bodies. They're very good. They're easy and flexible to use, and the blades are replaceable. The key thing when you're doing cutouts is to remember that once they're cut out, you've got to black the edges of the paper with a black felt tip marker. Because without those blacked, you get little white flares coming up when you're actually shooting it, and it spoils the entire illusion. No longer is the thing a rounded image against nice deep background. It's suddenly a piece of paper stuck on top of another piece of paper, and it's gone, it's no good. That, once I've got the characters, which are very messy to deal with, it's all little bits and pieces, I usually do a sky, which could be painted, could be a photograph from a book. This one's a photograph which I colored in. I just use simple grounds, which is mainly a shaded piece of color. You can add buildings, you can add trees. Again, cut out whatever you need, put them down. You've created the scene. The old man, the pram, is there, and you've got it. One of the problems with all of these little bits of paper, though, is that they are easily misplaced. I think I've lost something already. But what I tend to do is either put them in small little envelopes for each character. Each character's got a little envelope. Or I tape them onto the back in one little piece. I've done some things that were really too big for either envelopes or tape. Vast amounts of little pieces. That's what you're going to see right now. I've now got everything set up to actually shoot that sequence we were talking about. Problem when you're shooting cutout animation is shadows. It's a terrible problem, but we're stuck with it. It's because of all the pieces of paper we've got. This lady, where her head is about 5 layers of paper deep. So what we do, we've got to light it first, and we light it with lights as high as we can get. If you can get the lights way up in the air, the better off you are, because you get less shadow. The other thing we use is a large field, again, as big as you can, because it minimizes whatever shadow there is there. And finally, I also use padding underneath. Sometimes I'll put either a felt pad or a foam rubber pad underneath, which cushions it. And pressing down on this Perspex plate, it could be a glass plate, it doesn't really matter, holds everything down tight. Okay, now we're basically ready to shoot now. I've got a template here, like so, which is marked out in little marks along there, which tell me how far to move the pram each time as we're moving in. Using the front of the pram, we can do a shot, move a shot. That's flapped by tape so we can pull it out of the way when we actually shoot. So assume we're ready to shoot. We've moved into position. There we go. Another thing I've had to do is to tape down all the characters in here, because every time you lift this off, you see what happens. It moves. I haven't actually taped the old man down. I've done it with bits of sellotape. You can just fold it and make a little loop like that, stick it on the back. There's also other types of tapes you can use. There's double-sided tape. There's a new magnetized tape that I've heard about, which I haven't used yet. That's, we're in position now. We've moved the pram, click, click, we shoot it. Now, lift this up, template comes in, we move it forward a bit. We've had to move the feet. So move it like that. Down, shoot it. Click, click, done again. We're now, let's assume we're already into position now, just to save time. We've got the old man stationary. At this point, the old lady starts moving. Move a bit, again, flatten, click, move, click, and she's down. It's as simple as that. The thing is, once you're under the camera, you can play around a lot more, too. You may find things take on special shapes under the camera. Use them, you know, have fun. That's what cutouts is about, enjoy the fun of playing under the camera.
Oh, what a lovely little... Oh, what a lovely little...
it. Stop right there. This is absolutely disgusting, and I'm not going to stand for it. There. Hmm? Kill.